So, just trust us, and we'll see what happens. Authentic, it's the truth, it works. Tolerance based, we talked about that. Injury preventive, drills are designed to prevent injuries. Every drill we do is for care and prevention of your entire body, especially your arm, for those that are pitching. Because the arm's usually the first thing to go.
Or the knees.
Sandlot learning, we talked about that. Again, just the cross-specific training, specific drills that are all tied into the pitching, hitting, fielding, or throwing motions. Aim small, miss small. How many coaches do I have in the room? Are there any other coaches in the room? How many times have we said, let's get the ball over the plate? Right. Me? I'm the pitcher. Right. Just hit the glove. Just hit the glove. No. Hit the dime in the middle of the glove. What? Yeah, pretend there's a dime in the middle of the glove. Hit the dime. Because if you aim small, you'll miss small. If you're telling the kid to hit an area this wide, it's going to be out here. If you're telling the kid to hit this small of a target, he'll miss small. And that's what mechanics do. So it's aim small, miss small. It's different. I'm the biggest proponent. No. Breathe, hit the glove. Breathe, hit the glove. No, not anymore. And a lot of this stuff, again, I learned. Game preparation is not always, again, we talked about this, not always the best player who performs well or the best team that wins. It is the best prepared player and the best prepared team that wins. And again, World Series is a perfect example. There were a lot of major league teams that were more talented than the Giants and the Royals. They were the two best prepared teams. They deserve to be. How we do it? The instructors are the owners. No instruction will be passed off on high school or college students. We utilize carefully selected and qualified instructors. You will not see at any of our lessons high school kids or college kids giving lessons unless somehow, some way they became certified and passed my test. Your instructors are us. That I can promise you. The art and skill of coaching. Coaching is a God-given, this is what I believe. Coaching is a God-given gift and talent. It is very rarely developed. Usually, the best players in the game make the worst coaches. Why do you think that is? Take a guess. Best player in the world. Bad coach. Take a shot, Troy. Fill him in.
Because it comes easy to them.
Their way is the best way.
Yeah.
If you're not doing it as well as they are, they get mad.
They don't understand that you can perform at their level.
So it's the guys that research, guys and women, who research the game, who come up with the best process, the best drills, the most modern things, most scientifically proven drills. Those make the best coaches. Think about it. Think about the great managers in baseball. How many of them were horrible baseball players? Quite a few. What's that?
Most.
Yes. Bruce Bochy, average player, average catcher. Ned Yost lasted a few seasons. They studied the game. Engage the student. Encourage the right to ask questions. We talked about this and provide authentic answers. We do not. Here's a huge one. How many of you tell your team, go out, throw the ball around, and warm up?
Used to? Yep.
Okay. I know just about everybody does. I know you ladies don't.
What do we do first?
We warm up to throw and to hit. We do not throw and hit to warm up. The reason? Injuries. Your body is not warmed up. Your muscles are not ready to go. And you start throwing a baseball and throwing a baseball hard, and what happens? So before every lesson, there will be a warm-up. There will be exercises. We're going to go over some of them today. They're different. They're unique.
They work.
So, remember, we warm up to throw. We warm up to hit. We do not throw to warm up or hit to warm up. Classroom, we conduct schoolroom classes. Players and parents have a right to understand what they will be doing and why. I went over that before. We prefer to not conduct one-on-one drills. They are proven to be less effective than small groups. Players, especially friends, compete and help each other. Is that new to a lot of people?
Thanks.
How many of you have taken one-on-one lessons with just a coach? Do you think it would have been more effective if you had a teammate with you or a friend with you and you can help each other while you're doing a lesson? You don't think so, but trust me. That's scientifically proven. Okay. If anybody wants a one-on-one drill, look, I'm not going to say no, but an hour-long one-on-one drill, I'm telling you right now, you're not going to get as much out of it as having a group, the perfect size group is 4 to 6 minutes. It's more effective. Again, scientific studies have been done about this. That's what works. Research. We continually conduct endless research to find the most effective drills and ways to work. That's what I do constantly. Coach Mike does. Coach Mike does. Coach Troy. Coach Sherry. That's what we do. What are we, Coach Sherry? Neurotic?
Yes, a little bit.
A little bit.
Just neurotic. Just go. Shh.
Just don't tell anybody. Look at the white jacket.
We admit it readily.
Yes.
We admit it.
It's a healthy neuroticism. I don't care what anybody says. Repetitions. We keep track of player reps while working with them. Perfect reps are the key. Player ownership. We're talking about that. Practice at home. This is absolutely necessary. Win at all costs, again, does not exist in the NSOB environment. It's all about passion, enthusiasm, patience, authenticity, honesty, trust, hard work. Questions? Comments? Wow. Are you impressed yet? No?
Yes.
I think you're doing a great job.
Thanks. That's why I come for you. Hands-on ownership. Just, this is what we do. It's Coach Mike working with Caden.
Is that Caden? I can't see.
It's Caden.
I think that's
Caden. And that's me working with
Bronson.
Practice what we teach. You will be, we are your instructors, I guarantee you. NSOB's philosophies. I've been asked so many times over the years, what pitching philosophy do you use? What hitting philosophy do you use? What coaching methods and philosophies do you use? My first answer is this, and this is all, again, scientifically proven. It takes 1,000 perfect repetitions to create or break a habit. 1,000 perfect repetitions. Not a repetition for the sake of making a repetition. Doing it correctly, and that might involve your parent, your dad, your mom standing there watching you. Perfect repetition. It takes 10,000 perfect repetitions for something to become automatic, wired into muscle memory. Proven scientific fact. It takes 10,000 hours to video every one of your sessions. Do I show them to you? Do you learn from them? The most valuable teaching tool. I do it for myself. I play softball. I take video of me hitting. I bowl. I take videos of me bowling. Oh, that's what I was doing. Now I know. And you'd be surprised when you give something visual to your child to watch and you say, Nick, this is what you were doing wrong. Here's a video of you when you did it right. Here's a video of you when you did it wrong. Speaks volumes. Pictures worth a thousand words. Okay, my favorite part. It's a pitching philosophy. A couple months ago, Mike? We, my brother-in-law Mike, and my nephew Jonathan, who's over there, we went to the National Pitching Association biomechanics course. It was a 3-day program. Our goal was to be certified as a biomechanics coach in pitching, and we are. And what Jonathan got out of it was absolute, as a player, so the players are too, was absolutely priceless. And we're going to prove it to you out in the field. Okay? The NPA was created by a gentleman named Tom House. Does anybody know or have heard of Tom House? He is not affiliated with us. Okay? He is not part of this business. He is not part of the NSOB. He has nothing to do with us. The only thing he has to do with us is that he taught us biomechanics. Okay? And we'll be going back in February. There's 5 different levels of his certification. We'll be going back in February for level 2, which is conditioning, I think. Level 2 is conditioning. We'll be going back for that. Who is he? Pitched in the major leagues for about 9 seasons. He was a major